Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast, episode number 19, favorite Excel functions. Well, hey, welcome back to the Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com. Today's question, Tyler Nash.
Hey, Mr. Excel, what are some of your favorite Excel functions?
Well, Tyler, you can ask 20 different people what their favorite Excel functions are. You're going to get 20 different lists. There's 400 different functions in Excel. This is kind of tough to answer. I'm going to run through a few of my favorites. Now, next episode, we're going to talk about VLOOKUP, so I won't talk about that one today. But, you know, so here, I need to count how many X's there are. So we have some people and some weeks. And most people think that this would be equal COUNT, but COUNT won't work with this because COUNT only counts numbers. So one of my favorite little tricks is if you need to count text or numbers, then use COUNT A, and it counts anything that's non-blank. So there's 19 X's there, and if we add another X, see it increases. All right, so COUNT A, function number one. Another thing, because I'm writing books all the time, I need to create large data sets that just kind of have random values. And so, you know, let's say that you have a department staff meeting, and one of the people in the department have to run to get lunch, right? And we're just going to pick their name out of a hat. Well, don't pick their name out of a hat. What we can do is we can say the index of this list of people. Now there's 10 people there, so we need a number between 1 and 10. And so I'm going to use rand between 1 comma 10, put two closing parentheses, one for the rand between, one for the index, and there, Dixie is the person today. Tomorrow we'll press F9, and then it's Jake. The next day, Andy, then Ike, then Gina, then Dixie. See, now Dixie came up twice before everyone else was picked. That happens. It's random. It's like their name gets thrown back in the hat. All right, here's another one. I am always doing date math, and I'm going to talk about three different functions here. I'm going to talk about the date function, which is incredibly versatile, the year function, and the month function. So the way that date works is we ask for the date of 2012, comma 8, comma 15, and that'll give us the 15th of the month corresponding to this. But we don't want to have to enter the year and the month all the time, so I'm going to use two more functions. I'm going to say for the year, I just want the year as a function of what's over there in A, and then I want the month of what's over there in A, and then for the day, I want the 15th all the time. Double click to shoot that down, and we always end up with the 15th of the month. Date is incredibly versatile. Now, I could go on and on and on, but we should get a different perspective. And for the different perspective, I'm going to invite a guest podcaster in. Mike Excel is Fun Girvin wrote the book that you should go to next. Slaying Excel Dragons is a beginner's guide to conquering Excel's frustrations and making Excel fun. Mike actually teaches Excel at Highline Community College, and this is the textbook he uses all semester to go through and really get you up into level 5, the top level of Excel. But he starts at the very beginning. So Mike, what are your favorite Excel functions?
Thanks, Tyler and Mr. Excel. Let's take a look at the if, average, and COUNTIFS and SUMIFS. These functions here are awesome for beginners, or anybody at any level for that matter. So we'll start with the if function. Now the if function is great. You just think of it as it puts one of two things in a cell. So here we have a bonus situation. Sue's sales are $48,500, and we need to compare them, asking the question, are Sue's sales greater than or equal to the hurdle? If they are, which they are in this case, we need the word yes in this cell. But if the sales are actually $47,500, we compare this, is this greater than or equal to that? And we want the word no in this cell. So anytime you have this situation, one of two things are always going into the cell, you can use the if function. So I'm going to say equals if. Logical test, that's where we need to compare. So we click on the sales. Are Sue's sales greater than or equal to? Now this is called a comparative operator. We're comparing the number 47,500 to the hurdle. Now, when you do greater than or equal to, there's no single comparative operator for that, so you have to put the greater than symbol and then second put the equal sign. Now, this is a logical test. It only comes out true or false. Now watch this. I'm going to type a comma, and this screen tip is totally polite. Hey, it says, what value do you want in the cell if it's true? Well, we want the word yes. So I'm going to type in double quotes all text that you put into formulas. If you want it to go into the formula, you have to put it in double quotes. Now I type comma, and the screen tip is totally polite. It says, hey, what do you want me to put in the cell if it's false? No. And close parentheses. Now I'm going to control enter. Right now it says no, but check this out. Totally automatic. When I change the sales number to above the hurdle, it tells me yes. Now you can do the same thing for numbers. I'm going to say if sales greater than or equal to the hurdle, logical test comes out true or false, comma, what do you want if it's true? The $750 bonus, comma, otherwise, what do you put in the cell if it's false? Zero. I'm just going to type that one in, control enter. Now let's test it. Now we tested above, below, and you always want to also test it exactly right on when you have that equal sign. And there we have it. Looks like it's working perfect. One of two words in a cell or one or two number items. Now another function that's great, the average. It adds them all up and divides by the count. So students want to know their quiz average. Now I'm going to type AVER. And notice average function is blue on the little drop down. As soon as you see your function highlighted in blue, you can hit Tab. I'm going to take my selection cursor and highlight. Watch this. Control Enter. I don't even have to type that ending parentheses. When you have a simple function like average or sum or count, you can leave that last parenthesis off, and it'll put it in for you. Now I'm going to take my selection cursor and point very carefully to that little box in the lower right-hand corner. And when I see my cursor turn to a crosshair or angry rabbit, I'm going to click and drag. That copies the formula down. I'm going to click in the last cell and hit F2. Check that out. It got the average for Tina perfect. Another great function is COUNTIFS and SUMIFS. Now, Mr. Excel did COUNTA, that counted all the non-empty cells, but COUNTIFS is great. We can say COUNT JUST SUE, and it will look through this whole list. It won't count all of them. It'll just count the SUEs. This example with COUNTIFS, we have a COUNT, which means COUNT, IF, which means there's some condition, and S means you can have one or more conditions or criteria. So I'm going to type equals COUNTIFS. Yes, and then Tab. The screen tip is very polite. It says, where's the criteria range? That's all the values, comma, and then it's saying, what's the criteria? You simply click on SUE. Now I'm going to hit Tab and check this out. It'll count three perfectly. SUMIFS is not for counting with a condition. It's summing or adding. So I'm going to do SUMIFS. And there's just one extra argument. Before we get to criteria range and criteria, it says, what values do you want me to add? So I highlight those, comma, criteria range, comma, and criteria. Notice reading the screen tips really helps. Control Enter. Totally perfect. It added up just SUEs. Now watch this. I click in this cell, and then I'm going to hold the Control key and highlight those. I can check my number down here looking at the sum, and it looks like it got it right. Now you can take SUMIFS and COUNTIFS one step further, or as many steps as you want. Let's do two criteria. I want to count SUE and product one. So if you look through the list, you should see that we should get the count two. So COUNTIFS. Criteria range 1, just be sure to read the screen tips, comma, criteria 1, comma, criteria range 2. Whoa, check that out. And then comma, criteria 2, Tab. And it got it right. SUMIFS is the same. We just have to add an extra first argument. Sum range. So these are the values I want to add. And then check this out. The rest of the screen tips are exactly the same as the count ifs. Just read. Be careful to read your screen tips as you type your commas. And boom. All right. Throw it back to Tyler and Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next episode. Check out Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. This book makes Excel for dummies. look like it was written for rocket scientists.